So the Chavis says, a mechalik of the Beisai, monos for Shabbos, someone who is splitting, dividing, for his Beis portions on Shabbos, Yechiel lahatal girdle, he's not going to make a girdle or raffle. Lema, the Mishiated girdle, plainly Yechiel, and plainly Shaloi, to the one who gets this girdle, this raffle, he gets this chelik. But, who Shiyu, a chalakim shom. It has to be that they're equal. Meaning, this series when we're talking about girdles, making a raffle, or a
lottery.
It's a lottery, really. But he knows winning anything. It's just who gets which chelik. So we'll keep it with the word girdle. It makes it easy. So you're not making a girdle if you're splitting stuff amongst family members, and they're basically equal parts. You just don't want to give one person before the other person. That's why you're making a girdle. He's going to give one person first. He's going to be, you know, maybe I should get first, and why is he getting second? So you're just doing it in order that there shouldn't be kin of an am. Who's getting first? Who's getting second? So basically, the girdle here is not about the size of the portion. The girl here is for who gets first and who gets second. So that's okay. Aval macherim osir kibish makpitim zel zeh yevoyu le midah mishkan. Says the machaber, but to make a girl with not the beisoy, with other people, for them you're not going to make a girl, even if you're doing it lashvoysom, even if you're doing it just that there shouldn't be fighting who gets more covered, who gets first, still you're not allowed to do it on Shabbos. Why? Because they're makbid on the size of the portion. And if they see someone's getting a bigger portion than the next, they're going to get upset and they're going to end up coming with a midah mishkal, measuring and weighing how big the portion is. So midah mishkal is also on Shabbos. We'll see more in Shulchan Gimel. You're not allowed to measure on Shabbos, you're not allowed to weigh something on Shabbos when you're giving it to somebody else. So with Hershish, so if you go ahead and make a girdle, so you can end up, one person is going to be upset. You get a smaller person, a smaller portion, a bigger portion. Therefore, it's also to make a girdle when they are makpid themselves there. When people are makpid on each other, who gets a bigger portion, who gets a smaller portion. Why? But they're not makpid on each other. They don't really care who gets the bigger one, the smaller one. Therefore, you can make a girdle.
What if you know that your children are very makpid?
He's fighting.
Yeah, Rabbi.
They fall in the category of.
So we'll see soon that Bnei Beisoy is ahead to even if it's the Machmir. But you're right.
Just only with the
Echiel says, I won this one.
So far, Echiel, yeah.
I'm thinking of Eliezer. You
know. No, I'll get Eliezer soon.
Does it matter how you do the girdle to come into the Salacha? Because there are a million ways to do this.
So it doesn't make a difference.
I'm thinking of a number in my head.
No, but no, that's called the girdle.
That's called the girdle too.
Yeah.
Or you can have like a different colored piece of paper, or you can have tickets from somewhere with numbers on.
Correct. It doesn't make a difference. It doesn't make a difference how you do the girdle. As long as you're doing it through a girdle, we ask it. Why? Because the backfit. We'll see the Magen Avraham. There's three levels. There's people who you know for sure are makpid on each other. If you know for sure they're makpid on each other, it's also to split it even without a girdle. Mm-hmm. People that could be a makpid, could be a not, you can't make a girdle because the girdle is showing that they're makpid. That's why you can't make the girdle. It's showing that they're makpid. Once they're showing that they're makpid, they'll come with their midah mishkal. But they may say, I never makpid. So it doesn't make a difference if you're going to make the girdle. According to the Mechaber, the way the Mechaber is learning, we'll see some maybe there are more arguments. There's no issue in the girdle itself. The issue is to be makpid by splitting it through an akpada. Splitting it up when you're makpid. So if people are makpid, without a girdle even, if you look in the Magen Avraham, Siv Kot and Zayin, let's say the beginning of the Magen Avraham. Kibitz makpidim, mashma, to lach like the lay girdle, sorry, to split without a girdle is mutter. The dafko b'stoma, on renach, emakpidim, elim came, right to mahatol girdle. We say regular people are makbid unless they say they want a girdle. And then what's the issue with the girdle? Because they're makbid. And then you may come with a midah or mishkan. The os chazidah shabak pidim. Aval I adina shabak pidim. Even if you know that they're makbid, I feel lachloid beloy girdle osir. Even the split without a girdle is osir. The chashinin sheyvoyo lahaskir shemida. So here you see the first in the Mogan of Ramah is learning. Goyal is not the issue. What's the issue? Splitting amongst people who are backbid on each other. Why? Because I come with the middle mishkal, they come measure it. And measuring is Osir on Shabbos. That's the issue of it. According to the Mechaber, the issue is the being backbid to do it with middle mishkal. That's the problem.
How do you split them?
If they're makbid?
Yes.
You can't.
So you don't have makbid for
Shabbos. So they don't eat?
You can't split them up, yeah. If you come with a middle mishkal, it's a problem. That's what you said.
Maybe,
no?
Maybe they can take themselves.
What's the practical solution?
Yeah.
You have guests at the table.
You don't divide them. You let them take them alone.
Basically, they have to go hungry.
No, you let them take it alone.
Let them take them.
Yeah, so guests aren't the problem because it's yours. Get out of the power for the Jews. Here we're talking about something. We'll see soon that if you own everything and you're giving it out, there's no problem. Whatever you give the person, you should be happy with. We're talking about something that they're shutzim, they have it together. They have like a pool of food. They split it. So now they can't split it on Shabbos, they have to split it before Shabbos. On Shabbos, they can't go and split the food. The makra in the middle of Mishkol, they cannot split it on Shabbos. Split it before
Shabbos. That would be interesting. But Mitzat Sheni then, if at the end we're going to say that if it's the Baal Bayis, there's no issue,
right.
then why do we have the halacha of B'nai Beisa?
Well, since that's the head of B'nai Beisa. Then the Mechaber is going to say, B'nai Beisa, if it's the father's, doesn't make a difference, because anyway, he does what he wants.
So then the first halacha of their Mechaber is not... It's never
right. That's what he says. No, it depends if it's not there. It's not the father's.
Oh, okay.
But they're basically people who pulled together. Siblings got together on Shabbos. Uh-huh. And they brought food together. They pulled it together. They want to split it on Shabbos. So they usually are not macro on each other. Okay. Right? The Muhammad is at the end. But they're basically, even if they're makbid, if the morning Tana gets a morning Gedolah, it's not a problem. Because it's all coming from the father. So the main thing is when they're makbid. And the reason is because when it comes to measure. It's not really so relevant to them. It's not most people when they're eating, they don't have pooled food, they're not splitting it. They have your own food usually.
No, but I mean if you were allocating portions and you have guests. Are we not worried that there are maybe two guests sitting next to each other you can't going to compare?
They're going to meet the Mishkel, but they're not going to compare because whatever you give them, they have to get. After, they want to compare for it. But they're not going to compare it before they take it. They're not going to say, one second, you gave them a bigger portion than me. I want the bigger one.
But if it's sitting
there,
we're not worried that one's going to say, you got a bigger piece than I did?
Let's just say they say that.
Let's just say
you got a bigger portion than me, so what? It's not the problem. The problem is when you're splitting it, if you had the correct timer, that I should get a bigger portion, then they're going to come to a middle mishkan. But even afterwards, when he has the bigger portion, one gets canceled to the next one. One second. I have a schuss for the same portion you have. It's not true.
It's irrelevant if the Shiva Bachram buying, let's say, food for Shabbos together,
yeah,
they buy a kugel, they buy a chicken, and then on Shabbos they divide it up amongst themselves. This becomes a problem.
If they're makbid. They're makbid the exact size.
They have to say
lachatula. They're not makbid.
Huge problem. It's
not
even the size.
Right. Yeah, which part? Right. No, so single edge. But that's not the size. That's not the mishkan.
No, but how much?
But isn't that a problem?
No. Which part you get is not me the mishkan. It's not going to measure it. So what's the better part? So what's the worst part? It's not the size of the thing.
Yeah. The bigger flegel.
Yeah, the bigger flegel, yeah.
Yeah, you want that one, right?
Okay.
That's heaven.
So that's the story you have to remember. The problem with this sheep is when you're makbid on the size again, and you have a right to be makbid on it. It's about bias giving out, the guests have no right to be makbid. Whatever they get, they're lucky with whatever they get. the famous, I don't remember, Yaakov Galinsky. Remember Yaakov Galinsky? He's a Magen Yerushalayim, very short person. Yeah, Yaakov Galinsky. So he used to go around. He was a Magen. He used to go around the Ashmen, he was a Muslim. So he had a famous joke, he used to say, I read him a few times. The 20 years he came to someone's house. In the middle there were two portions, a big portion and a small portion. So the first guy takes the big portion for himself, his army, he took the bigger portion. So his friend says to him, not nice. Take the bigger portion, he says, not that hard, so he asked him, what would you have done? He says, I don't take the smaller portion, I'll have to do the bigger portion. He says, okay, that's what I did. Yeah.
So just so you know, like if they are Makbi, then the girl is Usser.
If they're Makbi, even without a girl, it's Usser. If they're Makbi, the girl is just showing us that they're Makbi.
Okay.
If they're Makbi, the Magen Avraham says, right, if you know for sure, you're dealing with Makbi, then I feel like a beloved girl, Usser.
Okay, but doesn't the girl solve the problem of Makbi?
No. Because girl means the Makbi, so they're going to come to meet the Mishkan.
But wouldn't the girl say, okay, we're going to just divide this by choosing straws or something like that? Then
no, so
there's they're not going to measure. You know,
no, so he has a good question, right? The girl is solving the problem. Yeah. If the Makbi do a girl, he solves the problem.
Yeah.
See, doesn't solve, we don't go that way. Because they're still... I'm still going to fight and still going to try to measure afterwards who gets the bigger piece. Yeah, Gerd is not going to solve the problem. That's right. Gerd does not solve the issue. That's the Gerd irritates the issue. It shows them acting.
But the Ramah says that girl is totally us.
So we'll get to them in a second. Let's see the Mechaber first. So it says, again, it says, the Nebesai, if you're doing it equal Chalakim, the girl is Mutter. And if you're doing it, if you have big portions and small portions, this is more your case. If you have bigger portions, so Torah is explaining you're doing the gerel just to see who gets which piece. They're both basically equal. If you're doing gerel, we're showing it to the market. But if you know what's bigger and what's smaller, and they're doing a girl who should get the bigger piece, then it's another problem. Then it's a problem of gambling. Sachem and Kuvia. Sachem and Kuvia is an issue. You're not going to go ahead and do something through a girl or through a lottery that one person should win. Why? Because they're not really Semicha Das. So you have a new problem over here of Kuvia, that you're doing the girl and you know there's a bigger piece and a smaller piece. Anyway, it's also because of the Sachem and Kuvia. But yes, I remember they basically. The bottom of the Rebbe said, "Mutl have the girl a full of money gedolah, connected money ktana, if nesh emakidim." The Rebbe said, "You could do even a money gedolah and a money ktana." What happened to kuvia? What happened to gambling? It's not a problem. Why? Because they're not makbid. Because it's not theirs. The Rebbe said, "It's not theirs. It's the father's. Father's giving it to them. He's making a raffle. Which one is the bigger piece, a small piece? There's no problem of kuvia. There's no problem of." Midor Mishkol, because it all belongs to the father. So the whole.
I thought with Mana Gedolah connected Mana Katana was more of a problem with Gezel, not Midor Mishkol. Where's it both?
Yes, there's a problem of Kuvia with his Gezel.
Yeah.
Yeah, and besides, there's a problem of Midor Mishkol.
Even if somebody's going to win a big piece.
Maybe you're right. By a big piece and a small piece, there is no problem of Midor Mishkol, because they know it's bigger, it's smaller.
Yeah.
Yeah, understand me?
It's more of a thing.
There's a problem of Gezel. There's more problem of Gezel. Understand me? Yeah. So by the base side, you don't have either problem. You have the problem of Gezel, and that's the problem of Makpidim Zelzer. Now, if you look in there, let's continue on the problem. I'm filling with the statif also is also to restatif my time off because people are going to make a jazz. Now, but after we're going to have a burro, I will stam schenim. If you have stam schenim, it's enam chavedim, there aren't chavedim. You have schenim, there aren't chavedim, but pidim, and they're makbir on each other. But fill hoch is shari lishol meadoli. They allow bar from each other. So if you have schenim, they bar from each other, they keep it in with gidim lishol. So I mean, see, I told you, Loigas Rina to Yavoyo de Isser. Take us about Isis. So you have shchenim, neighbors, they borrow from each other something, but they're makbir on each other.
They're not used to borrow.
But now they want to borrow something, like Peter said, they want to borrow something. The halacha is that you're allowed to do it on Shabbos, even though they're makbidim. And when you borrow something, he's going to measure exactly how much you took. Since it's not the derech to do that, people, shchenim and makbidim usually don't borrow from each other. Therefore, they weren't grazer on Shabbos. Much like they also don't have this issue. Don't shchenim today, not makbidim zeh. And when you borrow something, you're not makbid to give back exactly what you took. Vayim says to Sefer Tov Kufid Zayin, Umashmo of Shata Peskim, the Gavir also after Shechem. A Gavir is also even by Shechem, Chefat of Rambam, Perch of Gimel, also the Hapis, Shadayim of the Mecha Chamemke. The Rambam says, you're not making Gavir, but there's Dayim of the Mecha Chamemke. So here's a new Allah. It didn't happen to the Mechamah Zohar. The Rambam is saying there's an Isser in making a Gavir. The Mechamah never said that. The Mechamah said the Isser was Mido Mishkel. That was the issue. But if it's not a problem of Mido Mishkel, you're not worried about Mido Mishkel, there's no problem with Gavril itself. The Rambam of Rambam is bringing down the Rambam who says there's an issue with the Gavril by itself. You can't even make a Gavril on Shabbos. If that would be true, it's not going to help in a basin. A Gavril you cannot make on Shabbos, period. And the truth is, if you look at the Rambam says, Hagol, but also the heart of Goy with Shabbos, I feel like they are. You're not allowed to make a Goy with Shabbos even through Goy. Something you're not allowed to do, Goy cannot do for you.
What's the Atmanacha then? What is the issue?
So the Rambam says, it's Doyle the Mecha Chomemke. It looks like Mecha Chomemke. It looks like selling and buying. You make a Goy with Shabbos, even though it's equal pieces, it looks like Mecha Chomemke, it looks like you're buying and selling.
But that itself is also because of the Yidah Mishkan.
Mecha Chomemke, no, Mecha Chomemke, Mido Mishkel is Usher because of Mecha Chomemke. So the Rambam is a new Isser, and the truth is, it's either Dabar of here, Asa Kasha, or the Mog Avram, or the Ramal. The whole Mechaber does not say anywhere there's an Isser of Goyal. The whole Mechaber was saying the Isser is Mido Mishkel, you come to measure. And that's why it's Mato B'nei Beisar. Says the Ramal, Aga, also the Hatal Goyal, whose sheet is that? That's the Rambam sheet. That's the sheet of the Mogav Rambam brings down over here. That's also
Rambam, this whole...
according to everything should be also.
Right.
The whole thing should be also. Once you do a Gerah, everything is also. Even though it's Chalakim Shabbos, everything should be also. And until then, that's a question. The Chalakim is not going with that. Why is the Mogav Rambam bring it down? And the Ramah, that says that go, but also the half of Gerah. The Mashkos is not arguing with the Mechavah. And until then, it says it with Tzorachim. Because the Ramah, the Chayyur, is arguing on the Mechaber, and the Mogav Avram is bringing that Shittus Rambam, which is arguing on the Mechaber. And that would be an issue of Goyal by itself. The Rambam holds, Goyal by itself is also. The Mechaber holds, Goyal by itself is not also. What's the issue? The issue is if you makbid. Okay, Sikhwan Ches, Mishom Kubiyah, Hiksha, Mishom the Geboyim, the Tur Pasal, Mechashem Mishpot, Simon Rej Zayin, the Ein Gezel, the Kubiyah, Ayin Shom. There's no gezel by kubya of ayin simen lamadal simen shulayin. The mashma the yesh tzas iser b'davar. Last we come out that in the sachet with kubya there is a little bit iser. It's an avak gezel, looks like gezel, and therefore we hold it's awesome.
When we talk about kubya, is that like using dice or something?
Yeah, kubya is dice. The sachet with kubya is spinning a dice, and somebody wins.
Is that just on Shabbos or is it?
So he says that for the bechol it's awesome, right? The Chava says
no, but in the when the he, in the Shulchan he borrowed
no, it's not even Bechol.
Because this is a halacha in the Chushan Mishpat.
Yeah, it's even Bechol.
So that has, I mean, that's so how do you do this on Shabbos? How do you
if we start that? There's
no. So he says this. I will read that the Delik and Mani Katano.
But this is like the Rambam. This makes the Kasha the Tila.
No. It's two different things. There's one Gairo when you have halacha Shabbos. Equal portions. I'm not sort of girl to see who gets which portion. There's the Rambam asks that even that. There's two parts to the sefer. One part is Chalak and Shavos. That means the pieces are equal. I'm doing a girl only to see who gets which piece, who gets first. By the Nebesa it's Mutter. By Achayim it's also because it shows the Machbid and you may come to measure with see which is bigger. And then when you have bigger pieces, one bigger than the next, and you're doing the girl who gets the bigger piece, that's already a problem of Masachim Kuvim. That's a problem of Geza Matur Choro, it's also. And on that, the Mechaber said, but B'nai Beisa is Mutter. Even on that, B'nai Beisa is Mutter.
So Masachim Kuvim is only if you have
one bigger piece and one smaller piece. Yeah, Masachim Kuvim is only if you have a bigger piece and a smaller piece.
Because you're a winner.
A clear winner, right. If they're equal pieces and you're stirring it through a girdle, right, there's no problem.
And that's even usher on
Chol. Right, if it's a bigger piece and a smaller piece, it's also a fill of Bechol. Right.
So somebody does this would require be also to be an aid.
Correct.
Wow.
Right, so the Aratim. Okay, right now, the Aratim for today's girdles, for today's raffles. Don't pass it by phases. Now, there are a lot of attainment for today's Girolis. It depends what it is. The main issue would be when people pool together something and they buy something, and that is one bigger piece and one smaller piece, and they're doing a girdle to split it, that may be a Vesachim Kuvim. That means we put together money to buy, there was a sale, whatever it is, and we got different products. One product is better than the other product, then it could be you cannot do it through a girdle.
Even on call.
But to buy like a lottery ticket.
So to buy a lottery ticket, they give a tailor because there, the whole issue of the socket with Kobe is because you're not really Gurmidas.
Right.
It's not for a kind, you're not really Gurmidas. By a lottery ticket, everyone's Gurmidas. If they're not going to win it, you might have the dollar. Right. That's the head to the game, not just lottery tickets, even smaller things. When people put together whatever the cases are. First of all, the girls that someone's giving a prize, for example, for raffles and stuff like that, kids raffles, where that you're not giving anything towards it, that it's kosher, it's mutter. Because I'm giving it to somebody who didn't give me anything, so I make a girl who gets it. If you give money towards it, then the money that I'm taking from you, maybe you're not going to be a machna. It's machna with kind. You don't really want to give me the money. But same thing, if I'm paying for everything, and I'm raffling off to a bunch of people because they said Mishnayis, because they learned something, and now I'm raffling off and giving it to them, that's no problem at all. Because there's no smachta. The person, no one else gave me money for it. I raised money from other people to go buy prizes for people who are learning something. That's not a problem.
Just to be sure, on Shabbos, the Rambam would have a problem.
Correct. On Shabbos, the Mishnah's raffle, the Rambam will have a problem. That girl will be a problem on Shabbos.
But the Rambam have a raffle with bidding for Elias?
We'll get that soon. We'll get that in a second. Even the Rambam will be okay.
Yeah.
But that's, but the lotteries, they say, because when you give the money, you're going with us. The same thing when
the yeshiva that get together, if that's what they say amongst themselves.
Yeah, the question is they're really going with us.
If you buy a lottery, everybody, when you put in a dollar, you're
going with us. Yeah, it's more than going with us. You have no choice, really. It's a government thing, or they give other attention. Uh-huh. The main issue would be
when you buy a together,
when you buy a puzzle together, it could be not going with us, you're talking about the bigger piece. Could be. You know, and I also have my comment. We're together, and I want a better piece, maybe. But for sure, the lottery is that they have a cooler. Same thing with moistus. They have raffles.
Yeah.
Right, the girls have a raffle, maybe a pitch for a raffle. They give $100 for a raffle, right? And you don't win. So you gave me dollars. They're not giving a dollar. You're giving a larger sum. They're giving $100. And you don't win. Why isn't that the stuff going to prove you?
Mm-hmm.
Right? You're not winning. If you don't win, who's going to grab
your
dots?
I see.
So they think about it. There could be a bigger issue. So I say by tzedakah, it's not a problem because the money you're giving basically for tzedakah. You're not giving it for the prize. You want to get tzedakah, so you're giving you getting a tax receipt for Raya, you get a tax receipt, you're giving it for tzedakah. That's the hetter they give for raffles or moistus. To give such a answer. This is a chesh mishpat of the sugi, really. But any misachet mikuv, you'll be awesome. Because you're not going with us. Gambling could be a much bigger issue.
Right.
Real gambling, when you're giving large sums of money, a lot of you're giving a dollar, you're giving $10, whatever it is, for a ticket. When you're gambling, when you're giving large sums of money, you really think you're going to win. You're trying to win. And you lose the money, not after you gamble that.
The same with luck.
You walk away. No, you people walk away from. I mean, I never gamble.
No, you put 25 cents and you pull down the handle.
I don't know about
that. Stupid thing. Yeah. It's not that.
No, no, because you put 25 cents in those machines also.
All right, it's stupid.
And nothing comes out. Yeah, I'm talking about real gambling.
Oh, and the car.
So when you put out large sums of money, people walk away. They really have charot, they didn't. They never wanted to give the money. Right. Someone who buys a lottery ticket doesn't have charot after you bought the lottery ticket. Say they bought the lottery ticket. He's gambling the makna, $1, $2, whatever it is, he's gambling the makna. By gambling, most of the people who walk away from the table have charot that they gave the money. If they regret it, then it's not, that means you're not gambling the makna. That means you didn't want to do it. So that's a problem of zero. That's where Sakham Kubri comes in. Okay, a Sikram test. Shavak Pidim.
Tet.
Tet.
Oh, Tet. Tet.
I didn't say it correctly.
No, I was looking at the C, but Shavak
Pidim. Ukhastan, Talmud, the Mashma. Tafik, Shemaisu, Lehem, Shaloi. The Eid, Oise, Elash, Voysam, Kosham, Safta, Lil. For I am here, Deisim, Kuf, Samach, Sikram. This is going on the father. Who's doing it for the Bnei Beisar? It's only if it's Mishaloi, it's the father. So then the kids can't be makra, it's not theirs. Yisim Gemara Dafkuf and Test Matilim Chaloshim Alakachem Yomtiv Chaloshim means raffles. Avaloi Alamonai Shalchol, but you can't go ahead and do it on the things that was from the weekday. They was Kachem, but they had a split. So they did a girdle on it. They're allowed to do it on Yomtiv. Only for kachem that was shechted on Yom Tov, you couldn't do erev Yom Tov. But mona shel chayil, meaning portions from that were done, that were already able to be split during the week, for that you're not allowed to do it on Shabbos or on Yom Tov. Pesach Rashi shel Atzma, Pesach Rav, Paravid, Pesach Rav, the Rambam, we can fill dvar mitzvah, ein lahat al gerul. For dvar mitzvah, you should not do a gerul. Kolheichid the matzah the mevid ve'esmo. If you could have done it yesterday, that's the klal. For Shabbos.
But yesterday was in the girl yesterday.
What?
It was in the girl yesterday.
It could have done the girl yesterday. For
Yom Tov. This is more the chulas I mean.
Yeah. I told the girl they shouldn't do it on. This is the issue of the girl. This is not the issue of Mecca Chamech, right? Here now the one of Rebbe speaking about the issue of girl itself, not the issue of Mecca Chamech.
So the girl on Yom Kippur of the two girls.
Oh, so we'll get there. We'll speak about it. With Shabbos, the Cholding and Osir, on Shabbos, they can't make a girl, the Ikka left my partner with Shabbos, and they didn't do the girl on Shabbos, they waited after Shabbos. Me, I'm a mission of Pesh, Rambam, Tafka Shalchul and Osir. I was on Kachim with Cholding and Chari. On Kachim, he says, you're allowed to make any girl you want for Kachim. Mishum, Chivu of Mitzvah. I am a Tesh, Yom Tov Shom.
He's saying
Daf Yom Tov? He's saying Daf Yom Tov, not on Shabbos. So here you have one heter of doing something like a girl on Yom Tov for Chalakim, for the Kachim.
What's this for though?
For
Ain Dain? Why would Yom Tov?
Or is that to be more Kal? I don't know. It's like a Lefesh, I'm not sure.
What this is Shabbos. Specifically
the Manas? Yeah, because they're being right on Shabbos, you see they didn't do very much upon him. Why did they skip Lech upon him on Shabbos? The seven is split the kachim, the on Yom Tov. Why shouldn't I split the lechem upon him on Shabbos? Same exact thing, basically. So we see that Shabbos, if they didn't do it, so therefore we ask them on Shabbos. I'm not sure what the reason is. When we are nearly the chol zeh lechalak eizer dover asa b'Shabbos, I fill them up and also on Tuyeh. This is to split something. For example, kachim or lechem upon him. That's what we're talking about till now. Even in the place where they come to fight. If you want to save a fight, so you can't do a girl. Came back with Gemara. Abba lahato, girl, mi yom kaddish, and mi ala the Torah, shari, that's mutter already. Why? Because that's not done with the Mecca Chamemkir. What am I doing? You're not giving anything tangible. You're letting the person say kaddish or get an aliyah. For such a thing, the law is that it's mutter.
But again, if you say it's al zgoro, then what's the difference what it is? It's a goro.
What's isha goro? Isha goro is done with Mecca Chamemke. The Rambam says, what's isha goro? So, Morgan Rambam is having the Rambam. end of Sifan Zion, Shadayim will make a chamem. Mecha Chamem is only done with the Mecha Chamem for when I'm getting something.
How could you say that buying an Aliyah is not done with the Mecha Chamem?
Who says you like buying Aliyah, Shabbos?
Right, that's auction. You're talking about...
That's another issue. Here's a girl who gets the Aliyah. You're talking about buying Aliyah, selling Aliyahs. Forget the reception of Option Zion.
Okay, so that before we get to... So when you get an Aliyah and you're making a Dava...
No, that's a Shabbat too.
Because...
He's giving stocker. I don't give stocker numbers, Thomas. It's not Mecha Chamefe.
Even though you're specifying a specific amount.
Doesn't make a difference. It's not Mecha Chamefe. You're not buying anything.
Buying a Spiro or something.
Yeah, give it stocker. Well, that's Mutha. So the Rambam says, there's limit to Mecha Chamefe. So over here, when you're not getting anything tangible, or it's a Kaddish or an Aliyah, they're all Mati. So how are you supposed to feel like the B.M. Kippurim, Hayim Afisin, Mishaychet Mizorik, Hayim Kippur. They had a girl who would check, who would be Zorik, and they didn't get anything for it. Who had a Shchus, the Mishaychet.
But that can't bring right from there, because that's a Shchus, and the Shchus with Midash. So how do you extend that to...
Okay.
What about the Shnei Hasirin?
Yeah.
That's
the Midrash. Yeah, and it was Mutter.
And it was
Mutter. Yeah, Midrash for sure is Mutter. Only Midrash maybe it's also. Uh-huh. But the matter, ain't supposed to be Midrash, it could be it's only somebody you needed. They could have done this before, yeah, they could have done it for Erev Yomtov. So from the...
You think even the Rambam would allow the Elias also? Because there's no Mecha from Emkar?
No, it's buying Elias, somebody else.
No, there's no Mecha
Yes. This is even the Rambam. There's even the Rambam that says the girl by itself is also.
Why? Because there's nothing.
You're not getting anything. Nothing tangible. Mecha from Emkar is when I'm getting something.
So
he's not getting anything tangible, so it's not it's a Mecha Chamefe.
The Aliyah is not considered tangible.
Correct. An Aliyah or Kaddish, you say Kaddish.
The Charlie Chuba says that it's also to do Goron on Kaddish. Yeah, it says in the Charlie Chuba.
Yeah, okay, but the Mongol Rambam says it's Mutter. The Rambam here says that it's Mutter. You can make it Goron on everything.
Instead of Tzedek, sorry.
What? It's also do good.
But I think go on Kaddish and Mutter Shabbat, but I the answer.
No, Mutter Shabbat, something else. You're doing it for after Shabbos. You're doing it for Shabbos.
Okay.
Fine. So if that's the case, it would be Mutter not just for a Dvar Mitzvah. You don't see here that the reason why it's Mutter to make a girl, but so it's not tangible, it's called a Dvar Mitzvah. Not for anything is Mutter. It's also Mutter not from the Bir Halacha. We are lachas mashma. Look at them in the beer locker, the last one, Zell Zell. But the chef is that the map is Adab im Orchav, Gene Orchim, but Pisum Zell and Zell. Someone can make a girl for his guest, or the guest can make their own girls. Misha Yitel Chalker Tchila. Who should take his chelik first? If they're not makbezelze. Avaloisha Yitel Chalker Vachelik Haveru. Not that he should take his chelik and his friend's chelik, because then he's gaining something. Vatam, given the ancient nafkamina by Mamoy, there's no Mamoy that's taken nafkamina, but Misha Yitel Tchila, who rak Misha Matel Misha Yalel Lechadish, take the Mamoy of Rome. So whoever gets to get it first is not a problem according to the Zephyr. With any time making a girl, you're not getting mominess of it and they're not makpid themselves there, it's mutter because such a girl is not it's about itself. Only if they're getting something it's a problem. That's such a Shinchav Gimel.
The Mishnah Berurah that says that it only applies if you do a girl, special kind of girl.
But I permitted for him.
Sorry?
Any mutter, right, will have to go with a sefer to know, you'll have to go with the scores.
Tell us how to do with the girl while sefer, you're going to
teach us. Because I'll also have to...
You have to wait until you speak in 2 weeks.
The Swiss Yaakov says that only the girl will take a sefer, the girl will grow. They open up a sefer, whatever, if you read from the... We open it up, we open it up to what should happen.
Not going
to
tell us how?
How to do it, how to grow. But the half of the girl, if the score is, he said it's awesome.
It's a spooky thing. But the Mishra Rus is that's the only kind you could bring down from the...
I don't know if it means Mamas and Girl and Girl.
Well, he said that.
Yeah, as long as you don't write names on papers, then it's Mutter. So once you have the names on papers, he comes out to that's awesome.
You have all the Nistalim, you have all their names, and you choose that of a half.
Right, according to the Shubi Yosef. According to the Shubi Yosef.
Well, he brings both, right? First he says it's okay, and then after that he brings
The main thing is to do, truth is loved after. I think because of this mission rule here, I think, who says it? One of my friends, Bozno or from Zama, one of them say that this that they make the kids say Tillam or Shabbos or whatever, the Mishnahs, they make a girl on Shabbos with the tickets, comes out they shouldn't do it because it is. Where might a girl pick a number, somebody else? But a girl that has the tickets, one of the family come out there, it's awesome. A lot of family make it, but one of the family members say they shouldn't do it on Shabbos. And the other place they won't do it on Shabbos. They'll do it after Shabbos, and they'll tell the kid they won, they give him the prize. Because it is halacha. Because such a girl is also on Shabbos. Okay, Simchav Gimel. Mutalem and Chaveroi, here's the Shaila of Medida. Now, just a cloud before we start the Simen. There's people get mixed up with the different types of Medida, measuring. So, it's a Medida we'll learn Simen Shinvav. Measuring we'll learn in Simen Shinvav what Issa measuring is, and what's called measuring. Here, this Issa is not the Issa of measuring. This is an issue of Mecca Chamamke. It means I'm taking something from somebody, the next few seats we're going to learn, hopefully the first of all today, Alpha is Gimel Dalit, I'm talking about when you go and you're taking something from somebody else, and you're going to pay him for it. You're going to pay him for it. I'm not talking about in your house. In your house, you want to measure how much oil you're putting into a salad. We'll learn about that, why it's worth it. We'll learn about it a different time. This few seats we're talking about, you're not measuring in your house, you're taking something from somebody, and you're going to pay him for it. So if you measure exactly how much it is, it's like you're buying it on Shabbos. So you're going to take it without telling him how much they're going to pay you, or measure it exactly. We'll see in our office. That's the few see.
It also includes borrowing, or is it specifically?
No, borrowing also.
Borrowing.
Borrowing, you have to pay back. You have to return it.
If you borrow something
from a neighbor,
and
you're not paying back anything, you're not returning anything, that's the season.
This is not
the game.
Only if you're going to be transferring.
Only if you ended up giving him back what you took.
Because a lot of times you go over to your neighbor and you borrow milk, right? And you're going to pay them back. Is it going to be exactly the same as
that? We'll see. That's it. If you're not marking exactly how much you give back, it's mutter.
No, I'm talking about where you're not going to give the person.
If you're not going to give back, then you can measure exactly what you're taking. It's not this halacha. We'll see. Maybe other issues.
Mutter for Shabbos for even if there's no memka.
We'll see. No. Medida is also a Shabbos.
Right.
We'll see. Certain times medida is mutter. For example, you want to add something to your salad, right? If it's we'll see this at Tatum, that if you put too much, too little, it's not going to taste good. But that's mutter. You got to measure exactly a cup of oil for your salad. Otherwise, it's not going to taste good. Anything that needs medida, you're allowed to do it. So if you want to go to your neighbor and borrow oil for your salad, and all you need is a teaspoon of oil, and you say, I need a teaspoon of oil, and he measures exactly a teaspoon of oil, if you're going to pay him back, then it could be a problem. If you're not paying him back, it's not a problem. The same as mutter in your house, it's a mutter to take from your neighbor.
You can go with a measurement up to your neighbor and say, fill it up to here because this is what I need, if you're not going to pay back.
If you're not going to pay back, correct. And if it's mutter, to put it in your salad. We're talking about a case that it's mutter.
Yeah.
There's no problem with Dita B'Shabbos, which we'll see most of the time So we're doing medida today, it's not a problem. Because when we do medida today, we're makpid on a man because it's going to ruin our food. So there it's not a problem. We'll get to that, it should involve. Here, the problem is, this you see from medida because of metakomenta. Because I'm paying you back, we're trying to avoid mentioning the payback that I owe you anything. So muta lemon lechaveinoi, I'm going to look quickly this you see here because it's basically it's like one or two alokas, the whole thing. Muta lemon lechaveinoi, I'll tell your friend, malali kli zeh, fill up this kli, I fill whom miyuchad lemidah. Even though the kli is miyuchad lemidah, meaning I'm coming to you and I'm saying fill up this
cup. Measuring cup.
A measuring cup, a cup. Fill it up for me, please. So that goes to the merchant's house, says, give me a cup of flour. He's allowed to fill up the cup of flour and give it to you. Even though, you know, a cup of flour is measured, so you're not measuring in the cup. But that's, here's another thing you have to know. The medida, here is no medida really. You're not measuring it. You're taking a cup full. That everyone uses mutter. Indeed, is that I put it into a cup and I measure it in the cup only partially, then it's awesome. But to fill up a cup, that's a cup. That's a measuring cup. It's one cup. There's no way to medida. You're filling up the cup and you're pouring it into your food.
Even if the cups are made,
correct.
When it's exactly one cup, this one
correct.
Is exactly a half a cup.
Right.
Doesn't
make a difference.
Full, it's full.
Correct. So you let it go to your friends, fill me up this cup. You're not going to say the 2-cup cup or the 5-ounce cup. You can't say that. Mm-hmm. But fill me up this cup and I take it from him. It's not a chiddush, but maybe the lekeach might take beisai. The lekeach brings his own cup. For I will learn male li kli ze, fill this up for me. I will limdai the kli hamayuchim the mida, the lishbeth that says kelob shal lekeach, that is aser. So go take it from the moichim and say, fill me up this cup. And everyone knows this cup is meant when you buy from him. You fill up this cup and pay a dollar for it. Fill it up for me and you pour it into your own kelim, and then bring it home, then it's aser. That you can't do. But to bring your own kli, or to take the merchant's kli with you, it's mutter. I go, v'yesh makilim loyma, d'chosh e'ne mechama l'midah l'gamri. If you don't do it exact, sh'namayit ha'moysif ma'at, sorry, then it's mutter. V'chein ha'minik poshet limdoid, v'kli ha'moyuchil l'midah, v'lishpoch v'kelov sh'lokeach. You can do that. Why? Because you're not makbid exactly. So you let it go to your friend, even though you're paying him back, say, please let me have a cup of flour, and if you're not mapping exactly how much it is, then you can take it, pour it into your own kelim, and bring it home. For I just borrowed the chah, the summer of time of my kelim, and the end of Sivdal, and see more. It says about Rabbi Yechiel, the meat of fish, the rug of liver, the limchar boy, ma'at shari, the aim of Mishum Gazel, you're not giving back the same amount. You're giving back a little bit less, a little bit more, or you're paying him. You're buying it, right? You're paying him. So you do out the ball of shakom and give them a chach b'yomtev v'chein noam v'la hatol tabas the midah v'zeh hatol amoychem. He used to put a tabas, a ring, in the midah, so it wouldn't be an exact. That means, I'm coming to you, I want a cup full of flour, and the truth is, it's not really a cup full of flour, it's a little bit less, because there's a ring inside. That's called being mamayit a little bit and being adding or take off a little bit, then it's mutter. As long as you're not doing it exact, it's mutter. It's not David to make a command.
Maybe
it's not a problem. Again, here you're losing.
Well, that guy's gaining.
Huh? No, the moicher is losing. The moicher is losing. Because I'm buying from you.
I'm buying less and I'm paying more.
I'm paying you
for a cup and you gave me less than a cup.
Alright, it's not a problem. It's not. There's not this. Mecha Shemekha is not ribbis. Maybe I know. I'm charging you more, but it's not ribbis.
But it's funny, because let's say during the weekdays, we worry about that. You borrow someone's car and you have a half a tank and you fill it up, and we are worried about a small amount that's called ribbis, no?
It's not something like Pidim Zelze.
I thought even.
If it's not Pidim Zelze, it's not ribbis. Shchedim Habak Pidim Zelze is a problem. If you borrow from a neighbor,
okay,
and then makpid, so how much you get back, then it's Issa Rivas maybe.
Right, but I thought even your friend, you borrow his car, you do him a favor, you say, you know what, there's half the tank, I'll fill it up for you.
Yeah, so this, okay,
that's awesome.
No, so this is short mutter, because you the reason why he's filling up the tank is because he lent you a car.
Right.
So you're basically paying for the lending of the car.
No, he didn't.
Because you're using the car.
But
you borrow a potato from somebody, yeah, but I use the car. But you borrow a potato from somebody, right? You pay back a bigger potato. Here, you're paying it back exactly what you took. Here, when I borrow the car, I'm using it, I'm giving it back to you. I'm not paying you for using the car. Because you
use
the car.
So the extra.
Besides the gas.
Yeah. Really appreciate
yeah.
The car.
Yeah. Appreciation of whatever it costs you. If you want to rent a car, it costs you money, right?
But what if you borrow a potato and you pay back two potatoes?
So it depends. If it's Shechina or Pidim Zerazer, it's not a problem. It's a problem. That's why Shechinim should not be makpid on each other. They have Shechinim and Pidim Zerazer, they have neighbors that are makpid, they make them return exactly what they borrowed, then they shouldn't borrow from each other. They should not borrow from each other. Because if they're makpid on each other, then it's a problem. You borrow a potato, they pay back a bigger potato, it's ribbis. If you're makpid to get back, it's the same potato. If you're not makpid, it gives you a smaller one, you're okay. Then if it gives you a bigger one, you're also okay. But if you're makpid to get back exactly what it gave you, it's a problem. I saw
that. Then it's better not to take it at all. Tell him to take it, don't bring it back.
Yeah, you can do that also. Choose most of the shame if you borrow a potato or something, or an egg, or something like that. They're not makpid with chal if you pay back.
Yeah,
I don't expect it.
They don't expect that with chal. I had a story with a neighbor once. That my wife, they needed a can of pineapples. My wife lent them a can of pineapples. And I hope my neighbor doesn't watch this thing. And my wife gave them a can of pineapples. 3 days later, she returned a smaller can of pineapples. My wife didn't bother asking why. Fine. But she offered. She says, when you lent me the can of pineapples, I gave it to my kids to eat, and your daughter was downstairs with us also. And she ate some also. So I don't have to give you back a smaller can, because she ate some of it. Wow. And she gave back a smaller can.
Wow.
That's not easy.
When I came home, my wife told me the story. I said, fine, please don't ever lend a bar from the neighbor again. It's a problem. She came out and beat him. She said, but it's a problem. That's called a beating.
What if you...
No, this is one of the smallest issues I've ever had.
Rabbi, what if you borrow an egg, and it's a large egg, and you return an extra large egg?
It doesn't make a difference. You're not a pizza. If you're not marked on the size, you're okay. Okay. Seabed. Mutalem of the Chavei, Mal of the Klizer, fill up this clip for me. Well, the Mokhar, Nibnait Oysoi. I don't know how much it is, and I want to pay you for it. But fill it up for me. We don't know the exact size. Tomorrow we'll measure it out and we'll figure out how much I owe you. This is also Mecca from Emkir, or if the market to give back. I will let you ever tell me the pointers. Don't tell them, give me this amount. You don't have to give me a pound or something like that, but then you're doing the Mecca from Emkir. But if I say, fill up this please for me, and tomorrow we'll figure out how much it is. And the friend I bothered over here, how can you say tomorrow we'll measure it? If you're not allowed to do it on Shabbos, anything you're not allowed to do on Shabbos, you're not allowed to say that you can do it after Shabbos. So I can go over here with Matzah to say that tomorrow we'll measure it. So the Mishnah Berurah, by the way, is Kasha, brings up from the previous Gadim. They look in Sif Katan Ches, Mutin,
Sif Katan Ches of what?
Of Mishnah Berurah.
Ches.
Mutin. And after the deed of the Shabbos and Yom Tov and Kamokam, Mutala Skiroi. You don't mention it. Vayan Elsin and Shin Zion, Sikhes, the Osir Loimid of a plenty Esir Lamachar, you're not saying to do this tomorrow, Mash Osir Lasa Sayyim. Which you're not allowed to do today. Unless, of course, I say this is Shabbos Gret. But without that, it's Osir. You're not allowed to say, I'm going to do something tomorrow, they're not allowed to do our Shabbos. So here it's Mutala, why is it Mutala? The Ulai Rishum Shum Tzerech Shabbos Atiroi. The Tzerech Shabbos Del Matir. So here's a big heter. Something you're not allowed to do tomorrow. If it's Tzerech Shabbos to do it today, to speak about it, that you do it tomorrow, you have a heter. It's a big chiddush, a big heter, the Prima Gordon says. Some of you want to say over here, the reason why it's mutter is not a heter always when it's Serech Shabbos you could speak about tomorrow. It's only a heter because medida is not really an issa. Medida is a shvacha issa, so such an issa will make a law to say you could do it after Shabbos. But a regular issa, they won't make a law. But the Mishnah Berurah after the Prima Gordon, anytime it's Serech Shabbos, you need it for Shabbos. And you're not speaking about what you're going to do tomorrow.
We moved from in Aleph, we were talking about to like Spiro by Hanbani, let's say.
Right.
Days we moved to Muto Chaver, Lerman Chaver.
No, Aleph wasn't a Chaver, Aleph was Chaver also.
Was?
Yeah.
That was strictly.
Muto Lerman Chaver, Aleph was
that. Strictly Mecca for
that. No, you would pay it back. Right. You would pay it back.
Right.
It doesn't make a difference if you pay back, it doesn't make a difference a chenveni or a neighbor.
The point is it's not she'ela.
Yeah.
Which is strange because the...
It is she'ela. You borrow it to pay back. Saravatona.
Correct, okay. I think that's, you know...
Yeah, anything you're borrowing, I would think of she'ela from a neighbor is correct. Not to pay back.
Correct.
Right, no, here we're talking, you're going to pay back. Yeah, this is what I'm talking about when you're not going to pay back. So it doesn't make a difference a chenveni or a neighbor. If you mark it to pay back, then it's as if you're buying it from him. See, give up the lemon of Haveroi, tell me Bayim by Agurzim Dominion. Give me a certain amount of eggs or Agurzim or nuts. Says them with Avram Dominion, Shekin Derech, Palabayas, Kriyas Moinim, but that Beisai Leda, Kamuhu Leutu, Shlayitu, Elek Piatzerich. You know why you're allowed to say that? Because this, I'm not doing it without Mecca Chamemke. That's what I do in my house also. What I do in my house, I take 2 eggs, 3 eggs. So you see from over here, from this sieve, that the whole sieve, Aleph and Beis, was only offer with something that you don't usually measure in your house. I'm going to you, I'm borrowing something, I'm borrowing a big thing, a cup or 2 cups, whatever it is, and you don't usually use that in your house, then it's a problem. But anything you usually use in your house, it's not a problem, a fault. That's sieve gimel. We may go a few minutes over time. I think it's a good idea to do it. It's all part of the same thing. So Siv Dal, basically, I'll give you a small Dhamma, the Aloha gives that Dhamma here, that there's three things over here. Mentioning amount of money, how much it costs. Mentioning a middle, a measurement. A measurement and a minion, which is an amount. How many? 3 eggs, 4 eggs, 3 different things we're talking about over here. The most lenient of all of them is to measure an amount. Let me have 2 cups of soda, 2 cans of soda. That's the most lenient. A meter is a measurement by the pound. And then a schum is, let me have $2 worth or $3 worth. That's what the Steve is talking about. So mutabayma l'chenveni, teli bayim, v'heri moinim. The last thing that chenveni, the Mishnah Berurah says over here, l'adavka chenveni, it's even your friend. Chenveni is a bit of chiddush because it looks more like Mecca Chamemkir. Mutalayim of the Chenveni, tell me, Dalav Beyer, Behei Rimoinim, Ubavach, Lo Yaskva, Hashem Domin. You can't mention money. Means, let me have 4 eggs, and the Chenveni can't say, 4 eggs cost you $1. You can't say that. Well, you basically have to trust the Chenveni after Shabbos is not going to rip you off. But if you mention an amount of money, it's a problem.
But he's the good shopkeeper. He can tell you, you know, this cost $1.
Because it's a guy. Because he is.
How can he eat? Can
he
have
to give it to you?
On Shabbos.
That's a business. He has a store. And you need something at Shabbos. You go to the store, you take something.
You go to the Makolet on Shabbos, and
you know what is very common?
You say you have a guest, you need something in
the... very common. I'm not sure exactly how it works, but this whole thing is very common in hotels. You go to a hotel for Shabbos, right? So, I'm not sure, I never know top of Shabbos, I don't know, I'm talking about Semicha, but not that you pay for your own food. And I'm not sure exactly how it works, but the more you order, the more they put it on your bill. Mm-hmm. Right? It's put on your bill. So basically what you're doing here is on Shabbos, you're buying from the hotel your food that you're eating.
You prepay, usually.
So I don't know exactly how it works. If you prepay for the whole food or whatever you eat,
it's
in the farm. But there used to be things that if you wanted extra bottle of soda, they'll put it on your bill, no? Yeah. They have that? They have that, no?
Yeah.
And if you want to order more stuff, to put it on your bill.
Right.
So here, these people have to be very careful. You can say, let me have another bottle of soda. But you can't say, okay, so it's Pepsi and it's Sprite and what, how much does it cost? And then you take it. You can't do that. You can't discuss with them the price of how much it costs. The wine, you made the same thing. I know exactly what they offer by the hotels. But anytime you're in a hotel for Shabbos, and you're adding to your stuff more, and putting it on your bill, you have to be very careful how you ask for it.
What if you ask for a bottle of Coke, and the guy says, okay, that's $3.
That's a problem.
Right? Is that all right?
No, it's not okay.
Yeah.
But he's taking pill.
It's not okay.
He doesn't have anything.
It's not okay.
If you have
that's
a hotel,
his job to say to you. To
but you can't do that.
If you have a hotel that you just go and take from the super, there's a super under the hotel, you just take it and everything they write automatically to your thing. You know the prices. You can see the prices. They are all written there.
And that's also a problem. The prices are in there. You go read the prices. You gotta read that thing with the prices on top of it.
No, near under each item, the price is there.
They can't do that. If they have a price of the items and you go take it, it's also for you to read that paper with the price of the items. Also to do. See soon. That's also to do. And if they're mentioning a price, it's also. If I take it, they're mentioning a price. So we ask a Shem Domi, you can't mention the price, but let's go middle. Makaba says you can't say an amount of how much you want, meter wise measurements, but let's go minion. Let's go minion and scum midimin. Loimar. Haresh yesh lechab yod chamishim agoizim. Tell the chamishim acheim yesh lechab yod imeya. You tell, listen, I may take 50 from you, give me another 50, and it'll be 100 altogether. You can't say that. So by domim it says, Makaba says, you can't say domim bechal. You even take one. Schum Mida and Schum Minyan and Schum Domim is different than Shem Domim, Shem Minyan, and Shem Mida. Shem Domim is, let me have $2 worth. Shem Minyan is, let me have 4 eggs. Shem Mida is, let me have a pound. So that is Mutter. Schum is something else. Schum Mida and Schum Minyan is, you're making, you're adding up everything that you owe. You're making a calculation. I may have took this much, let me have a few more. Altogether, this is how much I have. That you can't do. So the Mechaber says that Domim is Asr, even if it's a Shem Domim. Let me have $2 worth of soda. You can't say that, according to the Mechaber. It's Asr to say that. But Shem Mida and Shem Minyan is Mutter. As long as you don't do a Schum. Schum means you calculate how much the total is. Then you can't. You can't make a cheshbon. Hago, the Rambam argues that the chem is schum domin, nami eli also el b'chai gavra. So the Rambam says, he argues in the Mechaber, and they all ask, the Rambam, why did they say yesh omrim? But the Rambam is arguing in the Mechaber, and he says that schum domin is also eli also b'chai gavra, shayim eteli b'kach l'kach domin, v'yed l'cha b'yed l'kach l'kach. Also only schum. When you add it up, everything together. But if I ask you for $2 worth of something, according to the Ramah, it's Mutter. But Lav Hachi Shari, Bechem Beschum Mida, Dafka Bechai Gav Asim. But Lav Hachi Shari. Now, but Av Hachi Gav Asim, Lahaske Domim Klau, even though you're not allowed to mention Domim, so after the Ramah have said that Domim is Mutter, Hainu Bedovash Ein Mecha Yedua. You can't mention an amount where the price is not known. If everybody knows the price, everybody knows the $2 worth of pistachio nuts is a certain amount, everyone knows the price, so then you could say to the waiter, let me have $2 worth of nuts, because you know exactly how much it is. But if you don't know how much that is, that means no one knows exactly how much $2 of nuts is, then you can't say, give me $2 of nuts. He's basically saying, I'll pay you $2 for it. You're not using it just to show you how much you want. Because you have no idea how much nuts come in $2 worth. Then it's awesome. But if you know exactly, let's say, you want a dozen eggs, right? And you know a dozen eggs cost $10, so that's $3. So then you have $3 of eggs. Everybody knows that means a dozen, then it's mutter. But if you don't know how much it's coming when you say the same domim, then it's awesome. Then it's mutter. Unless you add it up. Sorry. The meaning is to the Mekel only if it's a W Yadua. You know how much is coming when you say that amount. So the Ramah argues in the Mechaper, he says, if you save an amount of money and you don't know how much is coming, he agrees with us. So again, Dhamim, the Ramah argues in the Mechaper. Mido and Minyan, the Mechaper is also masculine, you can say the amount. As long as you don't do a Tzchom, it's Mutter. Now let's see the Ramah says cut in Dalad and Hay. That was okay? You got a few minutes extra?
Yeah.
The Tzchom Dhamim. And we'll also have two of us mashma, the also the haske domam klal. Right, this is the Ramah says chum domam is shem domam is mutter, but the mechaber holds also no matter what. Because of shem domam, the leis chum midah, the leis chum midah. Mashma the domam, after the leis chum, the chesed also. The mechaber holds he never allowed to mention money, never. Even if you know exactly how much is coming from that money, you can't mention it. The Ramah argues. She ain't mecha yedua, says the Ramah, because she ain't like kitzva. Or a chus a psika. There's no amount, we don't know exactly how much you're getting for it. Oh, also, why are you telling me the poshut or a base? Give me for a poshut or a coin in those days, or a base, or two psutim. A fill of noitel masha noitel loy. Even though whatever it gives you, you'll be happy with, you'll take it, still it's also. The oz, ain't loy, which ain't kavanos, a loy, masha tzarech. You can't say that his kavanah is to say, to give me what I need. So, any do my itwa, there's no way he's giving him. That's the call. You gotta ask for an amount if you know how much is in that amount. But if you don't know how much is in that amount, it's also to do it. And the same thing would be with the Shem Midah. Oh, look by the close of Dr. Marisim, nearly, to what the Lady Midah. But also the Havskir Shem Midah, Ella Badavash ain't Midasa Yidua. You don't know how much it is. So here's another chumrah we have over here. When you want to ask for the waiter, let's say, to bring you meat on Shabbos, and you say, let me have a quarter pound of pastrami. Now you don't know exactly how much a quarter pound of pastrami is. That could be awesome. That could be awesome. Because why are you asking for a quarter pound? You know a pound costs you $20, and you want only $5 worth. So instead of saying $5, say a quarter of a pound, which means $5. You can't do that. Because you don't know exactly how much you're getting. The only time you can mention an amount is when you know exactly how much you're getting. If you don't know exactly how much you're getting, Shai Mida and Shai Domer is awesome. Pirish Adafik is Aimer, the Marshal Tali Mida Gazin, by Domer's Aimer Gilan Limdite, the Oz Aimer Yadei Akam Maksaka Mida. Then it's awesome. Here's a heter if you're doing it just to say how much you want. Not because you're macro the price, it's more than a church. There's no way today that I make it. The Lord said, fill this clean for me, add a schnoffes. Schnoffes was like they had like lines in the clean. So the Lord, fill it up for me, fill that amount. I am chum. Now, here's another point in halacha. I think that was clear for now, no? The Mechaber holds, Domim is also to mention no matter what. Even if it's Dover Yadua, you know exactly how much you're getting for it, you can't mention money. So the boss says, anytime you're mentioning something because of we know that from that I know exactly how much I want, whether it's thumbim, whether it's minion, doesn't make a difference, it's always mutter. Masha Noyagir, Shakesin, Kloingi Niyach Tachma Kach Mois, this person left such a amount of money, or Kloingi Kachma Kach, for the Mocher Beshabbos, Kishenoisin Hayayin, the next day, and the person left $20. He could use up $20 on Shabbos. The Mocha B'Shabbos gives Yayin, Lekech, Machat, V'Oisin, the Kovim, Kvinyin, Yayin, Shalekech. He makes a little hole in a piece of paper to know how much wine he took. So he has $20 credit of wine. Each bottle will cost him $2, let's say. So he takes one bottle and he puts a little Machat, a little hole in the paper to show that he took one so far. Oser, why? The Oser, the Estakel, V'Oisin, Shav, Shekosov, V'Oisin, Shav, You never even look at that piece of paper that says the amount of money that he left. So here's this beforeish. If the piece of paper says how much money you gave, you never even look at that piece of paper. Same thing would be, you have a piece of paper in a hotel that says how much everything costs, and then you take, and the person marks it down on your piece of paper, whatever it is, it's also to look at such a paper on Yom Kippur. You can't go ahead and get the prices on Shabbos. But Mashmah, the author, Gamkin, Lichtenstein, with the Skois, Shkumois, you know that writing a piece of paper, this is very common. It used to be common by Eliezer, and Yom from Shabbos. We'd write a piece of paper, $1, $2, $5, $10, Uksulakeh Hayayin, and when someone takes the wine, Baniyah HaPetek, B'mokay, Shashem Ba'ish Kosov. They'll put that piece of paper by that person's name. So it took $10 worth, they put a $10 piece of paper by his name. To also Rikos Viskois Elu, to have his story adjaitis, is also to do that. So take like a garden, a piece of a seed or something, instead of money. So some schools have, I'm not sure what the header is, they have envelopes, and they have everyone's names. And when someone buys an aliyah, take a $5 or $10 piece, or $20, whatever it is, a $100 piece, and they put it in this envelope. Of course, it's also to do that.
Like the bond drive, you know, is a card, you measure a bond, so you pull down the number.
Yeah, that could be an issue. So start with this. So we all do that. Some schools may even have like
paper clip.
But what's paper clip going on?
On the school.
On the school.
You have 18 to 100.
Right, so that's also steridentis.
The paper clip on that.
It's also the 18, 20, 20, or 30 is steridentis. You're reading the amounts. And you put in the clip according to that amount. That's steridentis. That's a simple look.
There's different prices for the same thing. It's not, you know, it's not like you're pricing different.
No, but reading that paper is awesome.
So is the Isser doing it, or is the Isser reading the paper on Shabbos?
No, reading the paper. Sorry, Jesus. Now I'll read that paper on Shabbos.
So if you do it, so I'm just thinking, like, the person does it, then he puts it into an envelope.
Yeah.
Like, is the Isser of the sum of the Gabbai reading it?
Yeah, the Gabbai looks at the paper. It says 18, 25, 100, 200.
Right.
That's also,
but he gives you the card, you put in the...
Someone's reading it.
And you take your paper clip and you see which one to put it on. Aren't you reading it?
Yes, you're reading
it.
Here it says any piscois to have it has written on it an amount of money. Any piscois, it says over here, right?
That applies to
Yom. But also Gam can lift up with the score Schum Mois.
He continues later that a Gabbai stuck and they had a head.
It could be a head for Tzokha. We'll see soon. Maybe that's not a portion. But definitely, you know, hotels. The reason why I'm stressing it is because this is a common practice, I think, in hotels. You don't know exactly what a person owes. They'll put in papers or mark off how much he owes.
I permit it.
Here it says you gotta even read the papers that says the amount. Right? The Marshall also Gamkin Lichter with the score is Khomois, Kokehayan, Beneka Patrick and Mokum Shoshema Ish, cause of the Usher Lichroid with the score is Elu. You gotta read these papers to have a story of Jesus. So if you have pieces of paper with nothing written on it, and that is every bottle of wine you take, you put it into the guy's thing, that's fine.
Garret are papers?
No, garret is seeds. Same thing. You have any small piece of paper without any amount written on it. Mm-hmm. And you just add it to the person's thing, then it's okay. For Gabbai Tztoklo, Epshin du Mutano be Biskoitz Moshkosa Mishin Yishin Zayin. It's possible that Gabbai Tztok is Amutin. For Mekul Tzarech Mitzvah, there's a lot of read the story of Jesus. If it's possible to do with a garin without amounts of money, it's better to be machmir. The If all you wrote is the person's name, and then you make holes in the piece of paper, how much the person owes without amounts of money, then it says it's a mutter. Which would also be
holes on Shabbos.
So we'll see if we make holes on Shabbos. Which would also be if someone has a system, which I know there's I'm not sure it does that. They have a system, they don't have on the card $10, $20, $100, they have different color paper clips.
Mm-hmm. So
a yellow one is $10, a blue is $100. So this way, there's no shtar eidetis.
But you have to tell the person getting the aliyah, this paper clip is...
No, the person the person who's getting the aliyah is not doing anything. He says how much he's giving. So he buys it. The guy knows which color paper clip is which, and he puts it to the guy's paper. Right. The guy's card.
And he's allowed to give a skum?
He's not giving a schum, yeah. He's not giving a schum. He's not giving a schum. The problem is reading the story datus. So if you have colorful paper clips, then there's no list of bechlal. There's no amount of money.
Who picks the paper clip?
The government picks it.
So you can sit in a show that everybody knows that there's let's say these are four colors and you just put your name.
Why does the Baali have to know anything? He says he's giving how much money.
Right.
But he's more happy to remember.
You show that already. You daven there. It's one thing if you're a guest. You daven there all the time.
Yeah.
So you know. If you get it. So what you want to give, you give.
Usually a person, today in the shul here, let's say, right? A person gets aliyah. They give him the card. He puts the clipper he wants.
Yeah.
That's the way they.
I never saw that.
Yeah.
Usually he says how much he's going to give. No, he says how much he's going to give.
No, that's why.
And then the rabbi puts it on.
I wouldn't trust the guy.
Don't trust the rabbi.
So how do they do in the cold?
So here's the problem.
A lot of places they don't walk it up with flour and people don't pay out.
They make sure that they don't.
Yeah. That's a good way out. The shuls that do it with amounts is ahead there, we'll see in Zion, but sorry for mitzvah, but more banking or story dates. Let us finish up the boy here. Imagine the cost of Shem is the bottom, the middle is the cover, the biggest side there is, and the statue cost by Asian. Come up with Sarkin on Rosh, says, and the master, Megaboyna, that fill the Rishima by Alma of Salafis, the Simon. Even the Rishima you now make for a Simon. For Kolskut to make a hole, pick up the Menavim, say, pay if you're Aleph, Karashi, Risham, and the Kurz of Kai. They became Kolskin, the Othalafis Nekka for Simon. You can't make a Nekka for a Simon to know after Shabbos how much the person bought. And it's like Sarkin, the Megaboyna, he doesn't like the whole thing of making the column. Right. Next thing I'd like to finish with Gimel.